morning in the kitchen, Twin River has brought us Chef Trevor Sawchuk from Wicked Good Bar and Grill. And you have brought us some wicked good soup, haven't you?
Oh, of course.
And it's super easy for people to make at home themselves. So tell us what's in this recipe.
Well, it's roasted winter squash soup. Mm-hmm. Today, for the winter squash, I'm using butternut squash. There's also Spanish onions.
Which look like white onions,
yeah,
right?
Look like white onions. They're a little sweeter. They don't have that quite a bite as a white onion does.
Okay, that's good to know.
Granny Smith apples, they do have a bite, but I like the play of the sweetness and the you know,
definitely a nice balance.
Exactly. We're going savory with it. Some people do soups, squash soups, a little on the sweeter side. Mm-hmm. We're going the savory side. We're going with thyme. Mm. We're going with parsley in it. We also use the seeds from the squash as a garnish on the top of the soup.
I like that.
Yeah, exactly. So you utilize everything.
Plays
that
in
you
very
have.
Well. Mm-hmm. Tell us about some of the seasonings that you have.
It's simple. It's just salt and pepper. That's salt, pepper, and the thyme and
is
the
that
parsley.
Yogurt over there?
That is a sour cream.
Sour cream.
It's an optional ingredient. If you'd like to throw a little sour cream on the top
just
before you serve it, yeah,
exactly. Sounds good. And this, like you said before, this is a super super easy recipe for people to make. And on Thanksgiving, Wicked Bar and Grill, you guys are going to be having a whole menu that I know you guys are going to talk about in a little bit, but this is something that you can order right off of the menu or make it at home tonight.
Right.
All right, we'll be back in a little bit. Thanks. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thank you.
We got a great treat in the kitchen, a soup to warm everyone up on this chilly day. Chef Trevor, you're here from Wicked Good Bar and Grill in Twin River. And where do we stand right now? How do we get this started?
It's a simple process. We cut, we roast, we blend, soup's done. Really,
okay.
Really easy. We're starting with the butternut squash.
Sure.
Yeah, if you want to just grab one.
Okay. And make sure nothing falls
make sure
off
nothing
the
hits the floor. Okay. This one actually still has a sticker on it. Whoops.
Don't eat the sticker.
Don't eat the sticker. It's not a good thing. The tricky part of this is because it's round, it tends to roll.
Yes.
Try and find a spot where it won't roll on you.
Okay, so there's in between those grooves to hold it.
Yeah, exactly. And then keep the tip of the knife on the cutting board.
Okay.
And then that way it gives you kind of a pivot point, so it's not going to...
And am I slicing straight down the middle?
You are slicing
here?
Straight down the middle.
Oh, gosh. Oh, no.
It's all right. You can give it a little tap. Get through the skin.
Okay. Oh, my gosh. This is difficult. I think I've just wedged the knife in there, and I can't get it out.
No problem. You want a little assistance? Are you good with that?
Wait. I think I got it.
There you go. Yeah, once you get it through,
you can... Give it a little oomph, right? Okay. Maybe a lot of oomph. Once this is chopped, what are we going to... Hey, well, there we go.
There we go. Nice. That's all we... From here... Mm-hmm. What we do is I have a little bowl of water with a strainer over here.
Okay.
You want to save the seeds. So all you do is just kind of...
Do they taste similar to like a pumpkin seed?
Exactly the same.
Okay.
Yeah. You roast them. You use it for the garnish on the soup.
Oh,
you just
so
kind of
hang on to them.
Just kind of scoop it out. And for now, you just set it in the water and we can kind of deal with it a little bit later. Mm-hmm. But you want to get the squash in the oven. And roasting.
That's right. Okay, so here, you continue to scoop that one, and on this one, what should I season with?
Just a little salt, a little pepper.
Okay, I'll bring these on over here. Yeah.
And then you can grab a sprig of thyme.
Salt, pepper. Yep. I like pepper.
And a little sprig of thyme.
Okay. Just on top, place it there?
Well, actually, if you want, you could do it that way, sure. You could run your hand down it, and you could... pull the leaves off.
Okay.
That's it, yeah.
There it goes. All right, so we are going to get these roasted. These have to start first, and then the apples and the onions will be roasted too. We're going to show you how all this becomes soup a little later in the show.
Great.
Great morning in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Trevor is here from Wicked Good Bar and Grill. Roasted winter squash soup is what we are making today. Mm-hmm. Perfect for this time of year.
Exactly. And then I was kind of hoping that it was snowing today, but we got the snow a little early.
Yeah,
so
that's
whatever.
All right. That's okay. It's still
cold.
It's a bit of a teaser. Yeah, exactly.
It's still cold outside. All right. What do we need to do?
Actually, just to catch up on what we were doing last time, is we got the squash in the oven. It takes about 20 minutes at about 350. And then what you want to do is you want to get the oven, or you want to get the onions and the apple in the onion, or in the oven.
The tongue twister today.
Just too many words. Too early. Then leave it out in the oven for another 20 minutes or 25 mm-hmm. minutes until the squash is fork tender. Once you can, you know, pierce it with a fork, then you're ready to go to the next step.
Beautiful. Quickly, Chef, with the apples and the onions, have you seasoned those with anything before going in?
Same process. A little salt, a little pepper, right. and just a little thyme, and you can throw a little parsley on it as well. Okay. Just to kind of keep that same,
nice.
the same flavor,
yeah.
you know, throughout.
Right.
So where we are now is
we sitting have there looks good.
Wow,
our roasted vegetables.
So you really didn't even have to chop up those onions too much. Just break them up
just
a little
quarters,
bit.
Yeah. Really? Yeah, that's mm-hmm. about it. Just in quarters.
And you've also the seeds that we took out from before. You've roasted.
I started roasting those. Yeah, and they didn't quite have enough time, but I do have some that are already done mm-hmm.
and roasted. Would you do those for?
Usually they only take maybe like about 10 minutes, if that.
Yeah.
So basically, as you can see, it's kind of laid out.
Yes.
Put the squash in there. Put the apples and the onions in there after. Leave yourself a little bit of room. One pan, you know, do it all in
yes.
one, you know, less
easy,
cleanup.
Easy cooking.
Exactly.
We like that.
Now, from here, you could either do one of two ways. You could take the spoon and you could try and, you know, scoop the flesh out from the mm-hmm. Squash. I find what's easier is you turn it around mm-hmm. and you just kind of peel it right off. It's hot,
wow.
but, you know, it just comes.
But it is so easy because at
yeah.
that point, gosh, it's
exactly.
cooked for about 40 minutes.
Right. It's cooked and it just comes off.
I'm sure when it's a
so
little,
you take that off?
Little cool, it's a lot.
It's cooler, it's easier. Yeah, exactly. We take the skins off.
Mm-hmm.
We do the same thing pretty much for the apple because the apple is if you want
the skins on there.
Want to take this off too?
Yeah, sure. It's
okay.
a little warm, but you know, you might be able to handle that.
I'll do this.
Here you go.
Handy scoop it on
fork.
Anything.
Right.
Make sure you're not.
Okay.
Right in your hand there.
And then that can go right in the stock, which is right over here.
Right.
I used chicken stock today. You can use vegetable stock
okay.
if you want to do that. You can use...
Yum. And while we're doing this, we're getting everything peeled. We're going to add it into this stock. This soup is actually part of a Thanksgiving feast that you're having.
Yes, yes, it is. We're doing... It's a great deal. It's $15.95 per person.
Mm-hmm.
You can get the winter squash soup. You could get roast turkey. Mm-hmm. You could get a glazed ham. There's we're going to be doing a maple roasted sweet potatoes,
wow.
Vegetables,
so
salad,
yeah.
rolls, everything. You know, last year we did a plated dinner where you came in, you ordered your turkey dinner, and you got what you got. This
mm-hmm.
year we want to give people options. We want them to come in, and we want them to pick what they like, and then come back for more.
Have their own meal.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
Right.
And also, you're not skimping on dessert either.
No,
you
not at all.
You got the pies covered, pumpkin and apple,
and alamode if they want.
There you go.
Perfect. So these apples are done here.
These apples are done. So what we do then is we'll just take the apples.
Okay.
We'll put it in our stock.
Okay.
We'll take the
squash. Throw that in there.
Put that in our stock.
How about the onion? Just as is. Just throw those.
We can throw that in too. I already peeled it, so it's already
mm-hmm.
roasted. We can just throw that in as well.
Nice.
And then from there, let's see if I can get. What you can do is you can grab the immersion blender.
Okay.
And
here we are.
Just put it right in and give it a give the handle a squeeze.
Okay.
And just start blending it all up.
Nice.
That's it. Once it's blended, then we are done. You
right.
can throw in a touch of cream if you like.
Okay, that'll thicken it up a little.
It'll help. Well, yeah, it'll thicken it up a little, but it'll also smooth out the flavor.
Okay.
All right. That's going to continue to go.
Yeah.
I will work on this, but the finished product, that is what
it looks good.
Look
it smells
like.
Great.
It's thick, it's creamy. Warm you up on a nice cold day. If you want this recipe or for more information on the Thanksgiving feast, head on over to the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.